In this video, we can find the integral of the floor function of 2 to the x from 0 to n. This question is from Oxford Math. Before we begin, first let's recall, what is the floor function of x? The floor of x just equals the largest integer less than or equal to x. So now let's begin with our question. Because the lower bound is 0, the upper bound is n, so that means x is bigger than or equal to 0, then less than n. So that means 2 to the x is bigger than or equal to 2 to the power 0, then less than 2 to the power n. Then for the floor of 2 to the x, we're going to use k for this floor function. Because the floor of 2 to the x, just the largest integer less than or equal to 2 to the x. So that's why, so the k value, starting from here, 2 to the power 0, that's just 1. That's why starting from 1, then 2, then up to 2 to the power n minus 1. Then based on this result, so then we know for 2 to the x, it's always between two consecutive integers, that is bigger than or equal to k, then less than k plus 1. Then inside this interval, then what is the floor of 2 to the x? The floor of 2 to the x in this interval, just constant, just equals k. Then we want to know corresponding this interval, this result, what are the x values? So then just each term take a log with base 2. So then we have just x bigger than or equal to log base 2 of k, then here less than log base 2 of k plus 1. It's very easy to check the two statements are equivalent. So that means for x in this interval, the floor of 2 to the x just equals constant k. Because here k from 1 to until 2 to the power n minus 1. So that means we have a 2 to the power n minus 1, this kind of a subintervals. Okay, so now let's see when k is 1, then this is the very first subinterval. Then what is the lower bound of the first subinterval? So then here, just k is 1, use 1 replace here. So then the lower bound of the first subinterval, just 0. Then how about k equals the last one, 2 to the power n minus 1. So then this will be the very last subinterval. Then if we put this one here, then what is the upper bound of the last subinterval? So now let's see. So then when k equals 2 to the power n minus 1, then what is the upper bound of the very last subinterval? Then here, plus 1. Then these two cancel. So here just log base 2 of 2 to the power n. Then just equals n. Then from here we can tell. So if we consider all these subintervals, then they cover x from 0 to n. So now let's see our original integral. So that's just the integral from 0 to n, the floor of 2 to the x. You see, the lower bound of the first subinterval 0 just matches here. The upper bound of the last subinterval n matches here. So that's why we're going to write the integral as a sum of integrals. The integral in each of the subintervals. Then this is the lower bound, upper bound, then k from 1 to 2 to the power n minus 1. And also in each subinterval, the floor function is constant k. Okay, so now let's put all the information here. So then the lower bound, that's log base 2 of k, then here, log base 2 of k plus 1. Then k from 1 to 2 to the power n minus 1. Then here, just floor function. dx. Okay, so now let's see. Then here, let's simplify the inside part. Okay, then here, based on what we just discussed, in this interval, then here, the floor function of 2 to the x just equals a constant k. So that's why here, just k. So this is a crucial part of this problem. Now let's just evaluate this integral. Then just the upper bound, then minus the lower bound. Then here just the lower bound. Okay, so next, let's separate this sum into two parts. So this is the first part. So we're going to separate from here. So then the first one is k log k plus 1. Then this is the second sum. So here, just k, then log base 2 of k. Okay, next, because here this one is a k plus 1, here is a k. So then we want to do something to this k. So we're going to do this. So for k, we're going to put as k plus 1, then minus 1. Then we're going to separate this sum into two parts. Okay, so we're going to put this sum here. We're going to separate it from here. So then this is the first part. Then here, just a k plus 1, then times this k. Then here, just log base 2 of k plus 1. Then the second one minus, then the sum. Okay, so then here, this is the second part. So here, minus, then k from 1 to 2 to the power n minus 1. Then here, just log k plus 1. Then here, just log base 2 of k plus 1. Now let's write down the last one, last part here. So then just minus and this log k from 1 to 2 to the power n minus 1. Here's the k, then log k. Okay, so next, you see here. So here we have k plus 1, k plus 1. So then we want to do something to this part. We're going to use k prime for this part, for k plus 1. Then this one will be k prime. Okay, so then for when k is 1, then k prime will be 2. When k is 2 to the power n minus 1, so this one, k prime will be 2 to the power n. Okay, so now let's see the first part. Then here, just k prime from 2. Here's the 2 to the power n. So then here k prime, so log base 2 of k prime. Okay, then let's write down this part. Then, okay, now let's write down this one first. Okay, so then here just k from 1 to 2 to the power n minus 1, then k log base 2 of k. Okay, just this part. So then write this part. Okay, then here, just k from 1 to 2 to the power n minus 1. Then here, log base 2 of k plus 1. Okay, so now let's look at these two. You see, for the inside expressions, they have the same pattern. Okay, they have the same pattern. But then this sum from 2 to 2 to the power n, this one from 1 to 2 to the power n minus 1. So then here's the subtraction. So then when we do the subtraction, all the terms canceled, except the first term here, when k is 1. Then the last term here, when k prime equals 2 to the power n, then everything else canceled. So that's why here, just after we simplify, then the last term here, that's 2 to the power n, then here, just log base 2 of 2 to the power n. Then this one, case 1. Then here just 1. Then here log base 2 of 1. Okay, so then for this part, let's expand this sum. Because when case 1, here's 1 plus 1 is log 2. Then case 2, so here's log 3. So then expand this sum, then here we have log base 2 of 2 plus log base 2 of 3 until the last one. So here, just log base 2 of 2 to the power n. Okay, so now let's see this one. Because here, so log base 2, 2 to the power n, then they cancel, just n. So that's why for the first term, then here just 2 to the power n, then times n. Log 1 is 0 here. Then inside the parentheses, there's a sum of logs with the same base. So then based on the rule of log, so we can put them as log of a product. So then here just log base 2 of 2 times 3 times 4 until 2 to the power n. Okay, so now let's just the last step. Then here, so write n first, then n, then 2 to the power n, then minus 0. Then here, look at the inside. So 2 times 3, 2 times the 2 to the power n. That's just a 2 to the power n factorial. So then this is the answer for this integral. Thanks for watching.